Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross and Bob Cuddle back with you. Last week here on the program, Sid Vicious intentionally attempted to injure his opponent. Flying Brian and Z-Man came to the ring to assist the referees, Bob, and thank goodness they did.
If it hadn't been for the referees, there's no telling what would have happened if it hadn't been for Flying Brian and Z-Man. Vicious really got upset about that, Jim, and I tell you, he says he's going to pay them back. Remains to be seen exactly what he'll do.
Exactly right. And right now, let's go back 1 week ago here on World Championship Wrestling and show you just exactly how Flying Brian and Z-Man got involved with Big Sid.
Been beaten unmercifully by Big Sid Vicious. I think Jason Knight, and here comes Vicious.
Wait a minute, he's coming back toward the ring as the referees are trying to help Knight out. What's this, Jim?
Well, Vicious is going to help the referees get Knight out of the ring, stopping him. Here comes Flying Brian and Z-Man. They were standing by. Scheduled to wrestle next. And Sid Vicious is ready to take on both those men. The referee's holding back Pillman and Z-Man.
Vicious is motioning them to come on toward him, down on his knees begging, but the referees are between them, and they've got him cut off.
Well, Jason Knight still needs to be removed from the ring. He needs medical attention from the beating from that big man. And Vicious stood right up and looked Pillman and Z-Man right in the eye. Vicious.
Making his way to the ring area at 319 pounds, a member of the Four Horsemen, Big Sid Vicious.
Nothing more. I am what's happening in the NWA.
In the ring is opponent from Encino, California, at 266 pounds, Brian Carr.
Fans, let's hear these comments made just a few moments ago by Big Sid Vicious.
Last week, I told you, Pillman and Z-Man, you stuck your nose in my business. Well, today, you're going to pay for it, boys, and I'm going to take both of you, and I'm going to break you in half. And look, I'm serious, boy.
Sid Vicious with some very unkind words to say to Flying Brian and Z-Man, who will be taking on the Midnight Express a little bit later here on World Championship Wrestling. You know, Bob, wrestling Sid Vicious would be about like walking through a lion's cage with a pork chop suit on.
Jim, you're right, and I tell you, right there, Brian Carr was going to show you that he had some muscle and he had some power. It didn't even turn Vicious's head. He just came with that clothesline, lowered the boom on him right away. This man is, I tell you, he's impressive. He's vicious. He's mean. I don't know what you can do with a man like Sid Vicious.
6'9", well over 300 pounds. And absolutely not an ounce, in my estimation, of excess body fat. He is etched in granite. Big form there, right below the heart.
Jim, I'm too beginning to think that Vicious, in recent weeks, he's become the most dangerous member of the Horsemen, as far as I'm concerned.
I don't know how I can dispute that, Bob, after the, especially what happened here last week. It had not been, as we mentioned, for Flying Brian and Z-Man last week. There's just no telling what Sid Vicious would have done to his outmanned opponent.
Yeah. And I tell you, right now, he seems to be totally focused, as do the Horsemen, of course, on the Dudes with Attitudes, on Luger, on Sting, and with all of those. It's almost an obsession with him now.
Big Sid Vicious picking Brian Carr up. Carr may be soon to be a human frisbee here. Big Sid. Unbelievable.
That was definitely not a three-point landing.
You're right about that. Vicious, I know, would like to get his hands on Luger. Obviously, Vicious wants to be the next world's champion. What a matchup that would be with a Stinger. He's had some inflammatory remarks directed at Flying Brian and Z-Man. My point is, he doesn't like anybody.
No, and I think he's probably the most awesome, destructive athlete in all of professional wrestling right now.
Vicious picking up Brian Carr. And maybe, yes, it will be the pinball. 6'9", 330. Sid Vicious is devastated.
The winner of the match, Sid Vicious.
And still to come, Scott Steiner will take on Dirty Dutch Mantell. But we got to take another look at the powerbomb.
Luger, you're mine, boy.
Boy, it would give you nightmares to have somebody like that on your trail. Again, look at the power bomb from Sid Vicious. As he gets the opponent high to the air, the force with which he drives into the mat is incredible.
Fans, coming up, the master of the Frankensteiner, meets the man from Oil Trough, Texas. And that's next on TBS.